injection sites and techniques. Prior to giving an injection, the site in which the injection is going to happen needs to be selected. Primarily, two areas are used through the national BQA and that are approved. The first and most largely utilized area is the neck region. Some animal products can be given at the base of the ear, and most growth promotants are given in the middle one-third of the ear. Never give an injection site in the hip or the quarter or round or even behind the elbow. BQA always wants the injection sites to be in the neck or the ear area, largely due to the injection lesions are removed during the harvest time. Now, we'll also talk about two primary types of injection sites, subcutaneous and intramuscular. Prior to giving an injection, always read the label and see how the product needs to be utilized. If given an option between subcutaneous and intramuscular injections, always use the subcutaneous injection. Subcutaneous injections are given just under the skin and not into the muscle tissue. There are two techniques that can be used to give a subcutaneous injection. One, and probably the most popular, is the tenting technique. That is where the skin is lifted from the side of the neck and a tent is formed, and the shot or the injection is given there at the base of the tent that has been formed. To conduct the tenting technique, pull the skin away from the side of the neck and give the injection at the base of the tent formed. A one-handed technique may also be used to give an injection of a sub-Q type by injecting the needle in at an angle, pulling that skin away with the syringe, and then applying the injection. One-handed subcutaneous injection, enter the needle nearly parallel to the neck, pull the skin away with the syringe, and dispense the product. Ear injection technique, primarily used for growth implants, is given through the middle one-third of the ear. Start back off of the towards the outer portion of the ear so that the implant ends up in the middle portion of the ear. Some antibiotics and vaccines have been approved for an injection site at the base of the ear. And when giving injections at the ear, always make sure that that surface is clean and try to avoid blood vessels to limit any bleeding. Also, when giving an injection in the neck region, whether sub-Q or IM, never apply more than 10 milliliters per injection site and try to keep your injection sites a hand width apart when giving injections. The other area for injections that we are going to discuss here is the intramuscular injections. These injections go straight into the muscle. And the reason for this is that the muscle tissue has a higher metabolizable rate, and then the antibiotic or vaccine is absorbed much more quickly. You can use one of two techniques for giving an IM injection. One is by distracting the animal by tapping on the neck and then giving the injection into the muscular region. For IM injections, the needle should enter the muscle nearly perpendicular to the neck, dispense the product. The other, you can go immediately in with the needle with a quick thrust into the muscle to deposit whatever you may be depositing, vaccine or antibiotic. Select the appropriate needle length for the type of injection you are giving. The shorter needle on the left, 5/8 of an inch or less, is for subcutaneous injections. The longer needle, an inch and a half in length, should be utilized for intramuscular injections.